In this video, I will cover the process of saving and loading data. Since the source used in the previous video, using data in different scene is used, it is recommended to watch the video first. Let's get started. There are new features added in the previous process. There are coins that players can acquire. Each coin's tag is an item coin. And the box collider is set to trigger. The function for the player to earn coins and complete the game is in this script. In the script, the manager UI play component and the parent game object of coins are directly registered in variables. There are two public variables we checked earlier, and two integer variables that are only used within scripts. The numRemain coin variable stores how many coin game objects are. The numCurrentCoinGet variable stores the number of coins the player has acquired on the stage. When the player gets a coin, it adds 1 to the numCurrentCoinGet variable. The acquired coins are deactivated, and it runs eventGetCoin, a method that determines whether all coins in the stage have been acquired. If the condition is true, the amount of coins earned is transferred to a variable in the manager data UFO. It is then added to the total amount of coins the player has. I added 3 integer variables to the manager data UFO class. The numTotalCoinInPlay variable stores the number of coins earned in the stage. numTotalCoin is a variable that stores the number of all coins earned. numTotalScore is a variable that stores the number of points earned. The stage clear UI is displayed through the execution of the showResult method of the manager UI play class. There are 2 public variables in the manager UI play class. This is the text will display the coins and scores earned. And this is a game object variable that contains all the elements of the result screen. The result screen object is inactive. The exit button has been linked to the previously created method. Let's take a look at what's in the show result method. The amount of coins acquired in the stage from the manager data UFO class is entered into a variable. The number of coins earned is multiplied by 100 to create a score. This score is transferred to a variable in the manager data UFO class. The acquired coins and calculated scores are displayed in the UI text. And it activates the result screen. Save the data after the result screen is displayed. It has not been implemented yet, so it is left blank. Let's run the game. As I explained, when the player has acquired all the coins, the result screen is displayed. It is confirmed that the number of coins held is summed and stored in the manager data UFO class. In this example, I will show the process of saving and loading these two variables, the add number of the selected flying object and the total amount of coins held. There are many ways to save game data, but in today's example, we will be using PlayerPrefs provided by Unity. There will be many data items that need to be saved, even for simple games. For example, there are bool variables to be used to activate and deactivate music or sound effects, integer variables to store character levels and high scores, and float variables to store other detailed information. However, since PlayerPrefs only supports integers, floats, and strings, it is not possible to store various variables. It is possible to store variables in PlayerPrefs one by one, but since more code is generated than necessary, it becomes difficult to manage later and even increases the probability of creating bugs. A more efficient way is to combine these variables into a single variable, and save it, with using a list. List format supports not only game objects, integers, floats, but also classes. After gathering variables to be saved in the class into one single list, and save it. However, PlayerPrefs does not support the function of saving a list, so it must be saved after converting it to a string format. Let's take a look at the process for more details. As I mentioned earlier, the two variables that need to be saved and loaded are numCurrentID and numTotalCoin. I will change the location of the variables to make the code easier to see. Now, let's create a class to hold the variables to actually save. In order to convert the class to a one-dimensional array type, enter serializable in the upper line. To use serializable, you need to add the system directive. Add two variables to be saved within the class. And create a list that will make these variables into one variable. Let's create a method for save the data. There are some things to do before saving data. Since there is nothing in the class list, I need to add variables in the list. Let's create a method to add variables to the list. Let's put variables to be saved in the class list. Clears the list variable, otherwise it will overlap with existing variables. Then, let's write code that executes a method that adds a variable in the list. Now is the time to save the list variable. As mentioned earlier, PlayerPrefs cannot save type of list. So you need to convert the class list to string format. To use the convert to string function, enter the following directive. Now let's create two variables. One is a binary format or variable and the other is a memory stream variable. After serializing the class list variable as follows, add it to the memory stream. Then save the string with using PlayerPrefs and SetString. Enter the variable corresponding to key, and enter the operation of converting the memory stream variable to a string in the next value field. The making data save function is now completed. Since this save key is needed when loading data, I'm going to create and replace variables for convenience. Now, let's create a method for loading the data. Before loading the data, let's put a conditional statement. First, get the save key value. I made the code run when the stored data exists. The process of loading data is similar to saving it. The difference is, the saved string is converted to the original data state and then stored in a variable. The converted value is added to the class list after deserializing as follows. Since values have been entered in class variables, I need to pass them to the manager data UFOs variables. Let's create a method for this task. I will write a loop statement so that all variables in the class are passed. Assign the values of two variables in the class to the variables of the manager data UFO class. Then, in the last line of code in the data load method, write the code that calls the data get method. In the start method, I will write the code that will load the data when the game is launched. And finally, let's write the code to execute data save in the last line of show result method of manager UI UFO class. I will also write a debug code to check if the game data is saved properly. Let's run the game. You can see a message that the stage is complete and the game has been saved. Let's turn the game off and turn it on again. You can see the last selected flying object appears and the total amount of coins you had before. However, there is a problem. I tried to select another flying object, but it does not work properly. There seems to be a problem in the script of the manager UI UFO, which is responsible for the function of selecting flying objects. Let's find out the problem by debug code. When I run the game again, it does not match the ID value of the saved flying object. This is a problem that the loading of game data and the function of getting the ID of the flying object occurred at the same time. There are two ways to solve this problem. The first method is to create a separate method, and then make it run after a certain amount of time. Using invoke, you can make certain methods run after the desired amount of time has passed. This is a very simple method, but if you have a large amount of data stored, you will have to increase the waiting time. You can see that it matches the loaded game data. Also, there is no problem with the selection of other flying objects. This time, let's run a specific method after loading the data. Since there is no way to communicate with the manager UI UFO, I will create a class variable and then get the component. Since the method is private, I will change it to public method. Then run that method. I'm going to comment out the invoke command. Let's run the game. Even with other methods applied, you can see the problem is solved. That's all for today's video. Thank you, see you next time.